Hello students, this is the first session in the module for food and beverages operation second year, and we are going to start with introduction to beverages. So on the image you can see there are three images. One is coconut water, second is Coca-Cola, and third is a mocktail. So what is coconut water? It's a kind of nourishing beverage. What is Coca-Cola? It's a type of carbonated beverage which contain carbon dioxide. And what are mocktails? These are mixed drinks. So they are made by one or two different kind of ingredients. So these three are different beverages. But one thing is very common, that all these are beverages which do not contain any alcohol. So basically these are non-alcoholic beverages. So from this image we can get to know that there are non-alcoholic beverages. What the Oxford Dictionary says about the definition of beverages? So it says that any potable or consumable liquid other than water. So Oxford Dictionary does not include water in the category of beverages. So that is very important to understand over here. Overall, the beverages can be classified into two categories. One is alcoholic beverages, second is non-alcoholic beverages. The beverages which contains ethyl alcohol or C2H5OH are known as alcoholic beverages, and the beverages which do not contain ethyl alcohol are known as non-alcoholic beverages. In the previous slide, we understood what are non-alcoholic beverages. Okay. And then in the coming up session, we will understand what are alcoholic beverages. So first, let's understand what are non-alcoholic beverages. So overall, these beverages can be classified into three categories. The first one is stimulating beverages. Beverages which stimulates a human being or which stimulate the nervous system. They are tea and caffeine, because tea contains tannin and a small amount of caffeine, and coffee contains caffeine. So these agents stimulate a human being. That's why they are known as stimulating beverages. Then we have refreshing beverages, or the beverages which quenches thirst. So in the first we have aerated beverages, the beverages which contains carbon dioxide. Then we have squashes. Squashes are made with the fruit pulp. And then we have syrups, where the syrups are also made with the fruit pulp, but there is more of sugar in the syrups. And the third category is nourishing beverages, the beverages which provide nutrients to the body. And a lot of ethnic drinks are also part of nourishing beverages. Okay. Coming to the what is alcohol word, and how this alcoholic beverages came into the world. So alcohol is a word derived from the word al-kohl. Kohl is black. It's very fine straining powder which is used cosmetically. The Bible says that wine is the choicest gift of God to mankind. The Christ said that wines are blood of grape. The alcoholic beverages have spiritual connotations taken to divine heights by most religious except Islam, which strictly prohibits it. The definition of alcoholic beverages will become as this. Any beverage which contains C2H5OH is an alcoholic beverage, because C2H5OH is the only type of alcohol that a human body can consume. So it is very important that we should not consume any other alcohol apart from C2H5OH. When we classify alcoholic beverages, we can classify them into four categories. First category is fermented beverage, the beverages which undergo only the process of fermentation. And the beverages could be wine, which can be classified into table wines, sparkling wine, aromatized wine, fortified wine. Then we have cider. Cider is a wine which is made from apple, and perry is again fermented beverage which is made from pears. In the second category, we have brewed and fermented. So apart from fermentation, there is another step, that is brewing, which is added. And the beer is one of the finest example in this category. And sake, which is a rice beer from Japan, is also a classical example into this category. Third category, we have fermented and distilled beverages. So the beverages which undergo the process of fermentation first, and then they go for the process of distillation. These beverages are spirits. Various spirits are into this category, like whiskey, rum, gin, vodka, tequila, brandy. And then there are other like fruit brandies. So brandies which are not made from grape, but are made by some other fruits. So they could be there, like Applejack and Calvados. And then there is third category, which are known as compounded beverages. So what are compounded beverages? The beverages which undergo the process of fermentation, distillation, as well as addition of other botanicals. So this compounded beverages goes for three steps: fermentation, distillation, and addition of various herbs. And these beverages are liqueurs. They are very famous. One of the examples are Drambuie, Kalua, Tia Maria, Malibu. And then we have vermouths, and then we have bitters. So this is how the alcoholic beverages can be classified. So again, I am telling you, there are fermented beverages, there are brewed and fermented beverages, there are fermented and distilled beverages, and there are fermented, distilled, and various botanicals added beverages, which are known as compounded beverages. What is fermentation? It is a biological process in which sugars such as glucose, fructose, and sucrose are converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide as metabolic waste product. Because yeast perform this conversion in the absence of oxygen, ethanol fermentation is classified as anaerobic fermentation. And the formula stays as C6H12O6 plus yeast. And yeast is activated by the enzyme that is known as zymase. Then it produces two molecules of ethanol, that is 2C2H5OH, and two molecules of carbon dioxide. C2H5OH is the chemical formula for ethanol. So that's it in the session. In the next session, we will be covering distillation, types of distillation, and what are spirits. Thank you.